Today we start working on the new topology for our character. Retopology is a long and complex process, so I will try to start with something psychologically simple. For example, from the path curve, as it is already has some decent topology. I enjoy having a clean project organization. I usually create two collections, one for the high poly models and the second one for the low poly. So I duplicated her antenna and move it into the low poly collection. Then let's open the path settings and try to make it a little more low poly. Of course, I could make it even fewer polygons, but I tried to keep the shape smooth and beautiful, so I didn't go too far. Then let's convert it into a mesh. First go to the object drop-down menu, then convert and choose mesh. Now we will remove all unnecessary loops. I am merging all the vertices at the very end of the antenna. I have a custom hotkey for merge. It is Shift plus 6. I use merge a lot, so this hotkey is much more comfortable for my fingers. I am manually selecting the extra loops. And I just released a video on how to select loops this week. Just look at this! Oh my god, past me! What are you doing? I continue to select some of them, balancing between the number of polygons and the rounded shape. I press G hotkey twice to move the loops around. I noticed that the antenna didn't have a central line, so I moved loops to form it. And removed one half of the antenna. Then I selected the central loop and moved the 3D cursor to it by pressing Shift plus S. Finally, pressing the right mouse button and choose Set Origin, then Set Origin to 3D cursor. Now we can use the mirror modifier. Finally! I had no hard limits on polygon count for this character, so I decided to leave more polygons in favor of rounded shapes. Now we will move to the face. I like to start my face retopology from the eyes. I'm doing my retopology in the plugin Retopflow. It is really good and easy to use, but as always, you don't have to have it. You can do retopology with the Blender native tools as well. The topology of every human face should follow a few simple rules. Loops around the eyes, then the mask shape, then loops around the mouth, and another one a bit bigger, both around the mouth and the nose. Those loops will ensure that your model will be easy to rig and animate. And I'm resetting the origin point and 3D cursor to the world center so that the symmetry in Retopflow will work correctly. I'm avoiding dense topology. It's much easier to work with the fewer polygons. And if you need more, you can add them later. Forming a mask shape. honestly, retopology is a bit like puzzle to me. How to make polygons and avoid triangles as much as possible. At least in the places that will be deformed during the animation stage. And now we will jump to the mouth. You may have noticed that I jump from part to part and not even trying to sew all the pieces together. I found that it's much more manageable this way to keep a nice flow of loops. And for me, it's really simple to connect already finished parts rather than trying to grow the whole character just from a tiny piece. I'm avoiding triangles at all costs, since her face will be pretty deformed during the facial animation. One of the main difficulties you will face is how to connect dense topology, face for example, with much more low poly parts. We will do transitions like that in the most invisible and static parts of the character. In this case, I started creating many triangles below her chin, preparing for the transition to a low poly neck. So don't be afraid of using triangles. Just use them wisely. And finally, we got to the exciting part of the video. As you can see, she is smiling, but for the character to be suitable for facial animation, we need a calm expression of the face. So I need to get rid of this smile. Honestly, I should have done this before, but I want to show you that it's not difficult to change your model at any stage of the work. I want to be able to sculpt both high poly and low poly versions at the same time. So I joined them in one object with Ctrl plus J and start moving corners of the mouth, creating a poker face for her. After I'm done, press P hotkey and choose Separate by Loose Parts. Sculpting her face. To ensure that the low poly model wraps around the sculpt really nicely, I used the shrink wrap modifier. I'm deleting one side of the model, adding a mirror modifier, and back to Retopology. I'm hiding parts of the model to make it easier to work on the body. And finishing the neck. That's all for today. Thank you very much for watching. In the next part, we will work on her body. See you very soon. Bye!